Welcome back to the channel, everybody. On my previous video, I was talking about the nationwide truck that is right there. That truck had an issue. After the engine overhaul, we had some issues. The engine didn't want to start back on. It cranked, but it didn't want to start. And the air compressor went bad. Everything was running with no problems, but after the overhaul, these things came out without notice. Something that was not supposed to happen because everything was working fine, but you know, that's the way everything is. But now we got the engine running again, and I'm going to show you. But first, see, nationwide truck, and it has my sticker now because it's been rebuilt by me. See, fresh sticker right here. So let's get the key. And now this engine is going to start. Okay, all right. See. So start. All right. See. Now it's running. So I talk about the F over here. I show you there was something on the back that needs to be fixed. That is going to be fixed by the nationwide mechanics. That is a very simple repair that they have to do. And also another repair that needs to be done on this truck is going to be the fuel quantity valve. That one right there, that is the fuel quantity valve. That one is bad. That's the reason why the idle goes up and down, and that needs to be repaired. It has some air leaks and stuff like that, but now the air compressor was replaced, a new air compressor, so air is building up as we speak. See, now the air pressure is going up. After having the engine running for a while, didn't want to do it anymore, but now air pressure is building up, so that's good. Engine is running, so this truck is ready to go. Now, the reason of this video, what went wrong? Obviously, we know that the air compressor went wrong, and we had to replace the air compressor, and that's it. But what went wrong on the fuel system? Engine was running with no problems, and then suddenly didn't want to start back. So that is what I'm going to talk. So I can face you, okay? So what went wrong with this fuel system was then the fuel check valves, or the two-stage valves, or overflow valves, also they're called. This went bad. It actually got stuck with something in between the valve, and this didn't allow the pressure to get built. So as soon as we start the engine, the pressure was released back to the return area, so there was no pressure at all. And that was the reason why we had the issue with the fuel not building up. So the engine wasn't starting because we didn't have enough pressure. So to do this, we needed to replace the two valves, the low flow, the low pressure side and the high pressure side. They're located right on the fuel pump, and they're kind of like tricky to replace. They're not that easy, but they're not too super hard to replace. But you have to replace both of them. They're kind of expensive. I will say these are around like $200, $350, something like that, two of them. They're kind of expensive because you can buy the whole fuel pump for around like $1,000, we can say, probably $1,200 probably, depending where you buy it, because prices vary. So $1,200, and these two check valves are worth $300. Is a lot of money for those two check valves, but the labor to replace the fuel pump is going to be more higher than, you know, just replacing the two check valves, and that's the reason why we decided to do replace the check valves. So now, after replacing the check valves, now we can see then this engine is back on, and we can, you know, start it with no problems. And this is just another engine that is ready for the road. And as I did before, I did a regen to make sure that everything was working fine. That's the reason why you have to do special checks with your, if you are doing an engine repair, you have to check the engine in different ways, and doing a regen is going to be one of the best ways to actually do this, to check the engine truly. When you do a regen, you warm the engine up because the temperature increases. You actually put the engine on some stress. The stress of the engine increases at a very high level, and also you keep the engine running at high speed for a long time. And that is pretty good, because anything that is bad at this point is going to show up after a regen. So that is the reason why you have to do that. So, but up to right now, this truck is ready to go. There is not much things to do. As I said before, we have to do some air leaks, and probably, let's see what else. So we have some air leaks, and you can clearly hear there is a missing clearance light over there. There is a missing windshield wiper arm, and AC is working now. I fill it with clean AC Freon, so AC compressor is working. So oil change has to be done after having the engine running. So as soon as this truck goes back to Nationwide yard, they have to drain the plug, oil pan plug, so that way they can replace the engine oil, because it was very windy by the time we did this engine. So, you know, to make sure that none of the debris then could be captured inside the oil can damage the engine after a while. So right now, the best thing to do is drain the oil. And that is just a prevention. It's not necessary, fully necessary, but it's a prevention. And then, yeah, most of the things, yeah, it's just small things now. So now it's pretty much everything on place. And also, I was talking about the ABS and the transmission light on, because we have an automatic transmission. And I mentioned on my other video, but I'm going to mention it again in case you haven't seen the video. And we have a damage on the wiring right here. Let me go here. So we have a damage right there. You can see they're completely rusted, destroyed cables, because they were rubbing right there, see? And they were doing some kind of short and stuff like that. So we have to fix that. But that is something that mechanics at Nationwide can fix. It's not a major problem. And of course, maybe some small things as tires and stuff like that, mufflers and little things. Everything else is pretty much right on place. So after spending so much time, this is my old sticker, still has it here. So after spending a lot of time, and right now we are on 2022, right now we are on January 2022. This truck has been sitting from I believe October 2021. It's been sitting for a couple of months waiting for parts. Finally, all the parts arrived, and that's the reason we were able to finish it. But January 2022, parts are a little more easier to get right now. Seems like parts they're on the market more. So I hope that this continues like that, because it's very hard, because we have couple, like that one right there needs an engine, that one needs an engine too, that one right there needs an engine too, and let's see, that one, the brown one over there needs an engine too, and the little one right there needs an engine. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 different trucks, then they need engine repairs. And we have most of the parts for this truck. This one, we don't have no parts yet. That one is still in one piece. That one right there, most of the parts are here. That one is a DD13 engine, which is very hard to get parts for those. But, you know, that's how everything goes. So pretty much we have almost everything almost everything ready to with these repairs. But 2021 was a very hard year, and hopefully 2022 doesn't get harder than 2021. But if it does, we have to deal with it anyway. So this is all. This is the end of the chapter of the Nationwide Truck 328, which probably you're gonna see over the road. It's gonna be running here and there because they wanna take it. You know, they do all over the country loads. So if you are interested to work with them, just contact Nationwide. They have job for any type of needs. If you have, you are an operator, if you are driver, if you wanna be a dispatcher, they can help you with that. And hopefully nothing goes wrong with it, and if it does, we have to look at it and see what went wrong with the engine or anything else and probably caused some other damage. But right now engine is running fine, so we have to see this engine back after the first trip, probably after 5,000 miles depending how far they go. After the first trip, we have to see this engine back just to make sure if there is nothing loose, nothing out of place, nothing, then it is on need of any type of adjustment or stuff like that. So up to right now, this is all, and hopefully you like my videos, and if you do, please subscribe to the channel. I am very happy when you do. I'm trying my best to do better videos every time, explaining better things. Most of the time I try to do a lot of technical information that you are not going to find easily. This information is very, very hard to get and requires a lot of experience to understand. So if you subscribe to my channel, you are actually helping me to, you know, to get rewarded with the things I'm doing for you. So I hope you like the video. Subscribe to the channel, as I said before. Look for me on Instagram, franciscoamaya, YouTube. Check the description of the video. I have details how to send support to the channel. And as always, thank you for watching.